Before we're going to start, I just want to pay my respect to the traditional owner of this country, past and present. Thank you for having us in your country. If you're all here, I don't know if you're here or not, I would like to meet you. Well, anyway, I'm from Boorooloola, that's way up in the Gulf of Carbon area, right in the pocket of the Gulf. If you look it up on the map, you'll see us be 200k out of the Queensland border into Northern Territory. That's where I come from. So we had to drive all the way from Boorooloola to Darwin and fly down here. Yeah. And I just want to tell you about my country a bit. I want to tell you the names of my country. It'd be a bit strange for you, but like I'll call the names of language in our country. Like where I live, Wanganoola. And my other brother there from Wadawadala. We got a lot of names around the country. Wanganoola, Wadawadala. Melbourne, Mugurah, and you've got all other countries like Renewable, Namaru, Ruangama, Little Midian, Nanjarangajara, Yaramba, Nugajabara, all that country right across the Gulf. But when money-hungry people come in our country, they look, oh, that's just Boorooloola. That's King's Bay, the biggest tourist attraction in the Gulf. That's a road going to Queensland, Cape Crawford Highway. They see that Swearin River, but they don't know that they're in the country with many names already there in our country, our stories, sacred sites, dreaming sites in our country. That's what they don't know about. They come in there and look at that country, oh, it's the bushland. What they see is that they got dollar sign in their eye. I mean, that's serious, you know. People need to know about this sort of thing. And the whole reason why we came down here, because we're serious about this renewable energy. We're serious about this solar power. If I wouldn't be serious about it, I wouldn't be here sitting right now talking about it. Because that's the only way I look at it. That's the only way we can put a stop on people who want to come in with this dirty energy. We can tell them, we don't want your dirty energy. We want that clean energy. In our clean environment, for our future generation, and we want our people to be able to benefit from it, work with it, work on it. Because we got a big problem with MacArthur River mine in our country. I don't know whether you all heard about it, but it's been all around media and all that, ABC News. We've been bringing up all that issues about MacArthur mine, where they got this parcel, this little block leased area where they got on the mine site. But they didn't know that they're going to affect us downstream. They didn't keep their poison into the mining lease. They had no right to contaminate the river right down through the MacArthur River. Back in 2014, this is serious about it. 2014, independent monitoring came down there, and they've done the monitoring of the river, testing on the fish, and they proved it, that the fish was poisoned. They already proved that. So what they've done there, they took our livelihood away. The whole MacArthur River that's our livelihood. We fish off the river, we hunt off the river. They took that away from us. That's all the serious struggle we got there in our country, in the Gulf. I know it's really sad, but you know, we've been struggling for many years fighting against it. You know, like they didn't know that in that country we had different clan groups. Like we got different language group, Yanyuwa, Garwa, Kuranji, Mara, but there's a clan boundary too as well. Rumbaria, Mambalia, Wuralia, and Wialia. That's all a different clan group. And we know exactly where all that clan groups are in that area. You know, this has been taught to us from our elders. This has been going on from generation to generation. And today now, us young fellows like us now, our elders looking up on us. That we've been selected to take that leadership role back in our community. We got a big responsibility in our hand now. That's the whole reason why we're down here. And that's why we definitely need this clean energy, so that we want to be able to tell them that we don't want your dirty energy. Like what I said earlier, we don't want it. Yeah, and just another thing before I go ahead again. I've been working with Lock the Gate. I don't know whether you know about Lock the Gate. I'm one of the delegates from Lock the Gate here. so long ago we've been fighting together, and I know that this is not against this, not only just like me as an indigenous person, but even a lot of non-indigenous, we are working together on the same struggle. I know we've got a lot of good non-indigenous brothers and sisters that they're feeling the same struggle. So we've been teaming up together. By doing this, it's the only way we can get together, you know, if we unite together and keep it really strong. We're showing real leadership here. I think we should have taken this in Parliament and teach our leaders in there. Yeah. You know, yeah, and I got a lot of other things to say too, but I just want to say I got my brother there, Nicholas. Put your hand up, and my nephew there, Scott. We're from three grandfathers. Yeah. Yeah, we young people just come and stand up, and you're standing up for what we believe in our country. We're standing up for what we believe in, fighting for the king, climate change and all that. Yeah. And that's a good little short one for you, so thank you very much for listening.